I'll get us through this, just as long as you and me stick together. So why do you keep running headfirst into the same brick wall? I don't know. Pants on fire, you know. It's because deep down, there's a part of you that is still human.
No.
Part of you is. A dirty, shriveled, anemic little part of you that still mules for approval and love and a mommy and a daddy and a boo-hoo-hoo. Look at me, Tiger. Look at me. We gotta cut that part of you out like a cancer.
This is Ramina. She is a Pycnonemosaurus, a highly specialized ambush predator. Even as a tiny juvenile, she has intense carnivorous instincts. If it breathes, she will attack it. If it moves, she will follow it. If it lives, she will attempt to make that change. As a juvenile, she is highly social, but as adults, Pycnonemosauruses prefer to hunt alone. Ramina for now has the company of her brothers, and while together they can truly spell disaster to other juveniles. Group hunting is a skill all on its own and needs to be learned early on in life. One must not be too hasty but also not too shy.
Now that is the rule of a lifetime.
Thank you.
What do you do to that poor guy? You look like he wanted to kill himself.
Which poor guy are you talking about?
At some point, Ramina lost one of her siblings. It is pretty common for juveniles to die. Disease, accidents, starvation and fights can all doom a small carnivore. It is impossible to know for sure what happened to her brother. The remaining siblings have stumbled upon a very dangerous area. Slightly later, the same carnivore decides to pursue Ramina. It is a bad idea, because his backup isn't fast enough to keep up with the two. She will lead him to his death.
Stop it! You know how that ends.
An Odonisaurus is a curious plaything. It is something the siblings have not seen before. The herbivore is heavily armored, like a living stone. The two carnivores are actually hungry or just playing with the slower bird. Regardless, once the creature dies, the fun is over. Thank you. The siblings are bound to split their ways soon. They are almost adults now. Fate, however, seems to want to keep the two together in debt, and sends two adult allosauruses their way. The journey together is over and the deadly fate defeated. The two will now split their ways and never see each other again. Romina will from now on live alone.
Between us now sits a wall. But it's an illusion. For within every wall awaits a window. It's a door.
Real quick, every day is a fucking headache when you're in it.
Stalking in the bushes is her specialty. She spends a lot of her time doing this. Slowly moving through the bushes, carefully listening for any sign of life around her. In search of the perfect prey. She has spotted something, and it is rapidly moving towards her. An allosaurus, a fearsome foe. It could easily kill Romina, however she has learned her lessons. Yet this is her first attempt at killing one alone. She must be careful. The planes aren't always safe, even for those who are meant to exist there.
take a time out here. Talk this out.
I will never stop coming for you.
What?
Or I'll have to find out you like. I will find you.
Why?
I will ruin your life the way you ruin mine.
Dude, I don't even know you.
Hiding in the safety of the spruce trees, her attackers run straight past her. This encounter, however, convinces her into moving. The planes are getting too dangerous. It is time for Romina to move on. The sunrise has a special calming atmosphere to it. It is the start of a brand new day. And for Romina, this new start is as expected, hostile. A giant crocodile is on its way to a new water source. During wet seasons, the inland ponds become great places for crocodiles to live in. Unfortunately, during dry seasons, the water evaporates, not leaving enough to sustain the massive reptiles. Ramina moves far north. Here the weather is cold and miserable. She encounters another allosaurus. In the blanketing rain, she downs the carnivore with expertise.
Got pretty good at it, haven't I?
Yeah, it's almost second nature.
As the rain stops, Ramina is seen roaming through the thick forests. Forests aren't a place for her. She has great struggle moving through them. She is hunting, and she has spotted prey. She stops to listen every few steps. This way she can pinpoint the location of her prey better. Slowly following the sound, running too early could spook it into hiding. Yet another allosaurus.